भगवते वासुदेवाय
ॐ
नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय तस्मादहं विगत विक्लव ईश्वरस्य सर्वात्मना महि गृणामि यथा मनीषम् नीचो जया गुण विसर्ग मनु प्रविष्ट तये नहि पुमान अनुवर्णिते न
तस्मात्
therefore
अहम्
I
विगतः
विक्लवः
contemplation of being unfit
thus I give up
Ishwarasya
of
the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Sarva-atmana
in full surrender dedicated to Him.
Mahi
glories.
Gṛṇāmi
I shall chant
or describe.
Yatha
as much as possible.
Amanisham,
according to my own intelligence.
Manisham,
according to my own intelligence.
Nicha,
although I am low born.
My father being a great demon,
devoid of all good qualities.
Ajaya,
on account of ignorance.
And foolishness.
Guna Visarga,
the material world wherein the living entity takes birth,
according to the contamination of the different modes of nature.
Anupravishta,
entering within this material world.
Puyeta,
becomes purified,
jena,
by those devotional activities.
He
indeed,
Puman,
a person,
Anuvarnitena,
simply by glorifying the Lord.
Translation,
therefore, although I am born in a demonic family, even still, without any doubt, I may offer prayers to the Lord as far as possible by me. Any person who is engaged in offering prayer and hearing glories of the Lord becomes purified from the material condition of life.
Tasmadaham bhigatabhiklavaisharasya sarvatmanamahi dinami tathamanitam नीचो जया गुण विसर्ग अनुप्रविष्ट पूये तो जी नहीं पुमान अनुवर्णि देन दिस वर्स इज गिवन बाय चैतन्य महाप्रभु इन अनदर डिस्टिंक्ट फॉर चेत दर्पण मार्जनम Baba Maham, Dhabhavana Nidbhavanam. It doesn't matter where I am born. That is not important thing. Nicho. Even one is very low born. By freaks of nature, nobody can guarantee where he'll take his birth. Karmana Daivanatrena. I will have to take my birth according to my fruitive activity controlled by nature. Pratityamanani gunai karmani sarvasa. We are all completely under the control of the laws of material nature. Guna visarga. According to the quality or modes of material nature, we associate, we create another body. There are many places this thing has been described in the Bhagavad Gita. Maya, janta rurani maya. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddhesi arjuna tishtati brahmayat sarvabhutani. Just like that Jamnalal Agarwal, that he is now in the police custody. Now he is crying, save me, save me, save me. But nature's law is very strict. Daividhesa gunamai mama maya duratvaya. Once you committed mistake, immediately nature's law reacts and it is very difficult to come out of. Daividhesa gunamai mama maya duratvaya. But there is only one way, that is anuvarnitena, repeatedly chanting Hare Krishna. Repeated. That is the only way. Hare Nama Iva Kevala. That is recommended by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Kirtanadeva Krishnasya Mukta Sangha Paramvrade. This is the simple Kali Yuga. This is the only way. Kalodo Sanidhi Rajan. He asti eko mahanuga. This is the greatest qualification of Kali Yuga. Great personalities, they very much eulogize Kali Yuga, that there is simple method and so sublime, simply by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, one becomes completely purified. Bhuyeta jena hi pumar anuvarnita. Anu means repetition, and anu means following the footsteps of authority, spiritual master, anu. Our process is anu. We don't manufacture it. We simply follow Mahajana jena gatasya pantha. Mahajana, great personalities, great authorities, that is our problem. Guru Mukha Padma Vakko Chittete Koriya Oitko Arna Koriya Mani Aar. This is the Guru Mukha Padma Vakko, whatever is coming out of the mouth of the spiritual master, because he will never speak nonsense, he will also speak the same thing which he has heard from his Guru. That is called anu, anu, follow. So this is very easy. We don't manufacture things. What is the use of manufacturing things? We are imperfect. What we can manufacture? Whatever we shall manufacture, that is imperfect, because we are imperfect. The modern scientists, they are manufacturing some ideas. I manufacture and you manufacture some idea. You defeat me, I defeat you. Tatva apathishtya. In this way, I defeat you, you defeat me, that will not solve the problem. The problem will be solved when we follow the authority, anuvarnite. Then the problem will be. Prahlad Maharaj He is already purified. His head was touched by Nrisimhadev. He is completely purified. Therefore, although he was only child, 5 years old, he is speaking the, the gist conclusion of the Shastra, Anuvarnitya. He understood that I am not born in a Brahmin family, I am born niche, low-grade family, Asura family. My father was Asura, so I am born of him. So I have no prestigious position. Still, Krishna is satisfied simply by devotion and service. That has been already explained. So let me offer my prayer to the Lord sincerely, yathamanisam. As far as I have got my intelligence, I am not supposed to be very intelligent because I am low born. I am not born in a Brahmin family. Neither I am old enough, educated. Still, I have to offer my prayers. So let me try to offer my prayers by following the authorities, Anuvarnitya. Without any, what is called, doubt. Tasmad aham vigata vikra. Without any doubt. Why? That is the perfect way. If we follow the previous acharya, then there is no question of lamentation. Anuvarnitena, simply. This is very nice method. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's philosophy is that, jare dakho tare kaho Krishna, but you haven't got to manufacture for preaching. You haven't got to. This is nonsense. You simply follow what Krishna has said. Jare dakho tare kaho Krishna upadesh. Then you become guru. So Prahlad Maharaj became guru out of the 12 Mahajans. He is one of them. Sambhu, Narada, Sambhu, Kapila, Kumarama, Manu, Prahlad, Janaka, Bhishma. They are Mahajans. So we have to follow Prahlad Maharaj. He is our guru. Purva Acharya. Narada is Purva Acharya. He is disciple of Narada. Therefore he is Acharya. And his disciplic succession, there are sampradayas, Brahma sampradaya, Kumara sampradaya. Then anyone who is bona fide acharya, he can create his own disciplic succession, but one disciplic succession and the other disciple, they are not different, they are of the same conclusion. The Vaishnava acharya, just like our Ramanucharya, Madhyacharya, Nimbarka, Rudra Sampradaya, Vishnushyami, they are all of the same. Aradha Bhagavan, Vrajasutam, Krishnastu Bhagavan, that is their conclusion. There is no different conclusion, although they have got varieties of method, Suddhadvaita, Daityadvaita, Visishtadvaita, like that. They present the same philosophy in clear way, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu presents the same philosophy, that Achintam Hidave. That is Acharya. Acharya gives some way for simple understanding, the same conclusion. But according to the time, circumstances, they give a very easy method to understand. That is Acharya. Acharya is following strictly the previous Acharya, but according to the circumstances, he may make little changes. That change is not change from the original idea, no. So Prahlad Maharaj's conclusion is that I shall offer my prayers glorifying the Lord according to my capacity, yatha manusha. Everyone is not of the same intellect. You may be more intelligent than me. Another may be more intelligent than you. But that variety of intelligence does not mean missing the real point. The real point is the same. It's like Krishna has got so many queens, or in Vrindavan he was associated with so many gopi friends or cowherd boy friends. So everyone was Krishna's devotee, everyone loved Krishna. But there were varieties. Variety, vaichitra, it's called vaichitra. Krishna is not without variety. You see in the flower, Krishna says, punnaganda prithibhyamcha. The flavor is Krishna, we are studying in the morning. But there are still varieties of flavor. The rose flower has got a particular type of aroma, another flower aroma. So the Mayavadi philosopher, they cannot understand that the variety, vaichitra, is creation of Krishna. Although they are one, the same Krishna, punnaganda prithibhyamcha, but still there are varieties. Everywhere you will find varieties. Viseshata, and the Mayavadi philosopher, nirvishesh. In common English it is said, variety is the mother of enjoyment. So Krishna wants this variety. So you all are devotees. The central point is to love Krishna and offer him service, but that service may be a variety. Variety. You cannot claim that because you are serving Krishna in a type, and therefore if somebody is serving in a different way, must be approved by the authorities, you cannot criticize variety. Variety is the mother of enjoyment. The same vegetable, the same ghee, the same salt, same spices, but there are varieties of preparation. That is required. We must not, we want varieties. Bahunmukhi seva. How the central point is how the Vrindavan, Krishna is the central point. The cowherd boys, they are satisfying Krishna by going in the forest, playing with him, mock fighting with him. There is also variety. When he comes home, Krishna is taken care by Mother Yashoda, different dress, different foodstuff, variety. Similarly, when in the company of the gopis, there are varieties. So variety is the mother of India. So it is not that I will have to do exactly like you. I will have to serve Krishna, but no mental concoction, following the footsteps. Again, you can create variety, but it must not deviate from the original authority. That is what. So Prahlad Maharaj decided, Tasmad aham vigata viklava isharasya sarvatma. Real thing is, with heart and soul, everything. No reservation. Just like Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he surrenders to Krishna. Everything, whatever he has got. He said, Manasa deha geha jo kichu mor. Whatever I have got, no reservation. So what I have got in this material earth? He said, I have got this body, material body, lump of matter, and I have got my mind simply changing from this platform to that platform. Because mind's business is sankalpa vikalpa. We accept something, it is very good, and next time we reject. No, it is not good. This is mind business. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur said, I have got this lump of body. We are very much proud of possessing, but what we have got? We have got this body and the mind. And with the mind we have created so many things. This is my house, this is my wife, this is my children. Nobody is yours. You have come according to your karma, and they have come according to their karma, and it is a play only, that one is father, one is mother, one is son. It is by arrangement of the material nature, karanam guna sangas. Everything will be finished in the twinkling of an eye. Actually, it has no fact, but we think this is our position. That Bhaktivinoda Thakur said that my possession means some mental contraption and this lump of body, manasa deha geha. So therefore, whatever possession I have got, I surrender it. Manasa deha geha jo kichu mora, this is surrender. Hatvinu tuva padi nanda kisho. So the real process is to surrender to Krishna and act according to your best. Krishna will give you intelligence. First of all, we have to become sincere, heart and soul. Sarvatmana. Sarva means all, and atma means body, atma means mind, atma means soul. Three meanings of all. So, sarvatmana, your body, the other day I explained, karmana manasa vacha, by your working capacity, by your mind, by your words, this is called tridanda. We, Vaishnava sannyasi, we take tridanda, this is three. Karmana manasa vacha, by activities, by mind, and by words. The preaching is word. The word is the last, thinking, feeling, willing, then action. So mind should be settled, that I shall sincerely serve Krishna, because I am not expert, therefore, to understand how to serve Adu Gurba Asrayam, one has to accept Guru. Tasmad Gurum Prapadita, the Shastra says, in order to take direction, one must surrender to Guru. Krishna says, Tadvidhi Panipathena, Paripasnena Sivaya. That is the whole Vedi injunction. So, Prahlad Maharaj has already surrendered to Lord Brahma, Narada, and whatever intelligence he has got, he is trying to utilize it for satisfying the Supreme Lord. As yesterday we have discussed that how we can satisfy Krishna. He is Atmaram, Nijalabha Purva. He is already satisfied. with his own problem. What we can satisfy. So our that endeavor to satisfy means our satisfaction. The example is given that tatcha atmane pratimukhasya jathamukha sri. If we serve Krishna, then we will be satisfied. We are not satisfied by serving Maya. If we want satisfaction at all, then we serve Krishna. That is why. Everyone is dissatisfied. That we, because we are serving Maya, there must be dissatisfaction. There must be dissatisfaction. Nobody can be peaceful within this material world so long he is under the clutches of Maya. That is not possible. But these rascals, they do not know this. It is said everywhere. Māmīva ja prapadyante māyā metta. Bhoktāraṁ jagvatam sāṁ sarva-lopo mahesaraṁ śrīdāṁ sarva-bhūtānāṁ jñattā māṁ śānti mitchati. Krishna says, but we do not take Krishna's words. Śānti means we have to accept these three principles. What is that? Krishna is the enjoyer. He is the master. He is the proprietor. Bhaktanam yagvatapasam. You are performing yoga, you are performing tapasya, penances, you are observing brahmacharya. So many there are different rules and regulations. But what is the idea to serve Krishna, to satisfy Krishna? The sense will remain. We do not become impersonal, senseless or nonsense. No, the sense must be there. It should be purified. And as soon as we purify, then we have no other business than to satisfy Krishna. And so long we are not purified, we satisfy our sense. This is the difference between forma and bhakti. Thank you very much.